And Ezzy, let me, I'm going to actually start you out because I want to know, just in your opinion, how excited are you about playing in the Olympic Games, these first ones that you're doing? And is it hard to focus on WNBA basketball sometimes with the thoughts of the Olympic Games in your mind?
Great. Whoops. Sorry, I was on mute. So to start again, I'm super excited to play in my first Olympic Games. Obviously for Australia, it's something that I've, you know, wanted to do ever since I first started playing basketball. So that's really exciting. And in terms of just focusing on the two, I think I find it pretty easy to just kind of focus on WNBA, you know, when we are in season, and then obviously with the Olympic break, I'll have to shift my focus into Opals mode. But for now, it's just WNBA.
Gotcha. And how hard has it been to open the season against some of the best post players in the WNBA with, murderer's row, so to speak, of those first few games? How hard has that been to come into the season and just immediately have to go against some of the best post players in the league?
I think it has been hard. It's been challenging. It's been, you know, a great, it's been a great challenge. I think, you know, obviously players, you know, Sylvia Flowers is a great post player. So I think I'm just, you know, learning how to counter, you know, the bigger and stronger post players, and something I'm still learning how to do, but it's, you know, it's exciting. It's something that not everyone gets to do. So I'm just coming into each game, I'm, you know, really excited to go against great post players.
Awesome. Well, let's go ahead and go to Jeff Brown for a couple questions here. Jeff, go ahead.
Hey, Izzy, how are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
Doing pretty good. Thank you. Sticking with the Olympics really quick. Have you had any like conversations with Coach Sandy Brondello since that announcement's been made, or is that not really allowed because of, you know, during the WNBA season?
No, I think it is allowed. I, you know, obviously Sandy notified us prior to the announcement when we, you know, to tell us that we were in the team. So I've spoken to her then like a few days before the announcement, and then every now and then, but I think it's, you know, it's hard. Like we're both in season at the moment, so it's been pretty busy, but she's always been great at, you know, reaching out when she feels like she needs to. But yeah, it's not like there's a restriction or anything. But I think we're just, you know, both pretty busy.
Definitely. So obviously there's been a big, you know, coaching change with the Storm here recently. What was your initial reaction to hearing that Coach Dan Hughes would be stepping down?
I think it's bittersweet. I think, you know, Coach, you know, obviously was the one that drafted me a couple of years ago. And yeah, he's a great coach and he's done, you know, great things at different organizations as well. So, you know, although it was sad to see him, you know, depart from the role, you know, Noe's a great coach and she's obviously a player's coach as well. She's played in the league. She's got a lot of experience, you know, as an assistant, and she knows the team as well. So I think, you know, although we were sad to see Dan leave, it's really exciting for Noe and just exciting for the team as well.
Awesome. And then I talked to Jordan about this maybe a little while ago, where obviously a player that's coming off the bench, like, you know, sometimes you can get a lot of minutes, 20, 25 minutes a game, and other times it might only be 5 to 10. How do you kind of prepare for when you don't know exactly like how much role you're going to have in any specific game?
I think you just kind of have to get in that mindset of just being ready for every moment, whether it's, you know, 1 minute, whether it's 20 minutes. So just, you know, staying in the game, watching each possession, just being really present in the game, even though you're on the bench. I think just trying to do that is something that's really important because, you know, that minute or that 20 minutes could make a difference for the game. So I think, you know, we have a great team. So, you know, it's a lot of fun with, you know, being on the court and being on the bench as well. So I think we'd all do a good job of staying in the game while we're on the bench.
Awesome. And then since I don't see any other hands up, I'm just going to go a couple more. Couple like fun ones. Outside of basketball, when you were younger, what did you want to do when you grew up?
When I was younger, I think I wanted to get into, I guess like when I was really young, I think nursing was something that I kind of wanted to do, but I think more recently, get into psychology. So that's something that I wanted to do outside of basketball.
Awesome. I wanted to dig up dinosaur bones. So,
sorry.
I said when I was really young, I wanted to dig up dinosaur bones.
Oh, I mean, nothing wrong with that.
Yeah. How about like a favorite TV show or anything you've streamed lately that you've been enjoying?
Well, I just started watching This Is Us on Hulu. Nice. I've heard a lot of good things about it, but I started watching it like a couple of days ago, I think, and I'm already about to finish season one. So it's definitely something I'm binging at the moment.
Awesome. And then like favorite recent musical artist or one you've been listening to?
I've been listening to J. Cole at the moment, so his new album, The Off Season. But favorite artist or someone that I listen to all the time is Sam Henshaw.
And then last one for me, did you have any like either like favorite like board game or video game or anything that you played maybe when you were younger?
Board game, video game, probably like on the PlayStation or something like Crash Bandicoot. I play that a lot with my siblings. Nice. What was the other one? Ratchet and Clank, that one as well. But I didn't really play a lot of board games. But yeah, mostly those two.
Awesome. There's a new Ratchet and Clank coming out in a couple of weeks.
Oh, is there?
Yeah, for PlayStation 5.
I'll have to check it out.
Definitely. Cool. Good deal. Thank you, Ezzy.
Well, thank you.
Thanks, Jeffra. And thanks, Ezzy, for joining us. We'll have Kiana Williams step in here for just a second. All right, let's go ahead and open it up for questions for Kiana. Jeff, I think you are the only question asking person on the call. So if you want to open us up, or I have a few ready to go if you need me to, but go ahead, Jeff.
Oh, sure. Actually, let me get recording going. Okay. Hey, Kiana, how are you doing today?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. Thank you. Thank you. Obviously it was a pretty abrupt coaching change here. Just give me your initial reaction when you heard that Coach Hughes was stepping down.
I was shocked. Was not expecting it at all. You know, especially like, you know, just thinking back to the pre-draft process, I remember, you know, he called me a few days before the draft and, you know, he was telling me he'd love to have the opportunity to coach me, and he was hoping that, you know, I didn't get drafted before they had the chance to draft me. So, but super happy for him. You know, when you feel something, you got to go with your gut feeling. And he knew it was time to retire. So, just happy for him, happy for his decision, and happy where we're headed.
Definitely, definitely. And then leading into that, talk about now being under Coach Noel Quinn, like what are you most excited about playing under her?
Her energy, you know, she has a unique energy. You know, she's not really like going to yell at you, but she's going to demand the best out of you. And I was seeing that in training camp. You know, she was the court coach for when we'd scrimmage, and, you know, just her knowledge for the game. Obviously she's been in the league a while playing, and now she's coaching. Now she has a head coach role. So super excited. And I know I'm gonna learn a lot from her. I've already learned so much from her just from an X's and O's standpoint. And I'm just excited that I get to, you know, pick her brain the rest of the season.
And then one more thing about Coach Hughes. I know he had spoken about, you know, like kind of scouting you for a few years. Did you have a relationship with him at all before, you know, I guess towards the draft, or was that more him scouting you from afar?
It was more him scouting me from afar. I remember the conversation we had before the draft, he was just telling me that he remembers me coming to one of my high school games when I was like 14 or 15. So I had no idea that he was even at the game. So yeah, we've had like, he's been watching me from afar. But, you know, when I was younger, I'd go to the San Antonio Silver Stars games, and, you know, obviously he was the coach there for a while. So we've always had that, you know, like connection. But I was really looking forward to building our relationship this year. But like I said, super happy for him. You know, when it's, you know, when it's time and you have that feeling, you have to go with your gut.
Definitely. Let's see. I think I'll just do a couple more quick ones, like kind of fun ones that I just did with Ezzy as well. And then if Jeff has some questions, that's cool too. Okay. So like outside of basketball, when you were younger, what's something that like you wanted to do when you were growing up?
It's actually weird. I wanted to be a pilot. Nice. I don't know why. I was actually afraid to fly. But when I was younger, I just, I still do it sometimes. You know, you look up in the sky, I'm like, I wonder where that plane's going. But yeah, I wanted to be a pilot. Obviously I don't want to be a pilot anymore, but yeah, that was something I wanted to do when I was like a toddler.
That's awesome. Very cool. My grandfather was in the Air Force for a lot of years. So,
okay.
Yeah. So let's see, favorite TV show or like streaming show that you've been binging lately, maybe?
Lately I've been watching, The Startup is on Netflix. But my go-to is Law & Order, SVU.
Nice.
You can never go wrong. I feel like I've for sure seen every single episode, but there's so many episodes. He's like, oh, I don't really remember what happens. Let me watch it.
Yeah, for sure. Let's see. Favorite either musical artist or one you've been listening to a lot lately?
I have a few. I'd say J. Cole's up there. Rod Wave. Kendrick Lamar.
Nice.
I have a lot of favorite rap. I don't have one single favorite, you know. I kind of just put my music on shuffle and I'm confident on what song's gonna come on. I can let it ride.
Awesome. And then I think just last one for me, either like a favorite board game or a video game when you were younger.
So I have three older brothers and they'd always like either play Madden or sorry, 1 second.
No problem.
So I have three older brothers and they'd always play like, you know, Madden or 2K or, you know, some type of game. So I guess growing up, I liked playing Madden. I'm actually pretty good at it. I think at Stanford, I'd shock a lot of the football players at Stanford. You know, I'd hop on a game and beat them every now and then. Board games. I don't really play board games. But yeah, video games, I have to say Madden.
Awesome. That's awesome. Thanks, Kiana.
No problem.
Saying I'm old enough to have known Ice-T as a musician, as well as a famous actor. I bet both of you don't remember that, but that's all right. Hey, thanks for joining us, Kiana. I appreciate it. We'll be back after the game tonight with more from the three players selected during the game. So thank you very much for joining us, everybody. We'll see you later.